Hello and welcome to Off the Bench, all thanks to the TAC. Drinking, driving, they're better apart, and that's all thanks to our great friends at the TAC and their Towards Zero Safety campaign. A big show coming your way, a father-son combination from the Calaville United Premiership winning team on the weekend. Looking forward to having a chat to those two gentlemen very shortly. We also have Nathan Currie with a country footy roundup. Hannah Driscoll back for a comprehensive weekly wrap. A terrific feature story about three retiring players from the Rochester Football Club. And of course, our great country clashes. And the show wouldn't be a show without this man, the 87 Premiership winning player from Stawell. But as he likes to remind us, 15 seconds before we go to air, he was also the 1995 raging red hot favourite in the Brownlow medal and got no votes. Liam Pickering, welcome, Picks.
Good to be here, Wayne. I'm glad that you started off like that because
are you really?
I want to start off with the EJ Witten game this time last week.
What a great success that was for prostate
cancer. We were talking about, and here's some vision of the EJ Witten game. Wayne Schwass, who is
probably
a 49-year-old man.
The most uninspiring speech from the coach.
And it's fair to say Wayne was nothing short of an embarrassment.
Mops it up. Burnley footy's very slippery.
Look at that. I mean, what happened to you, Swatty? You had...
Wispy Watson, who I text during the week.
Look, and this is late in the game after you'd had about three fumbles for the game. That was it. Yep. You've done your hanny.
Yep.
And you've now since spent time in the sick bay, Keithy.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the end
set
of the game,
up
of course.
The skipper.
Johnny Brown. It was a brilliant kick, wasn't it, by Brownie?
Took the mark 18 seconds after the final siren.
It was. He did. It was a bit late, but what a kick it was. And seriously, Swatty, it's over.
I know.
That was embarrassing for you.
I tell you, I knew when it was over.
Embarrassing for us.
I knew when it was over when I turned my phone on and Mick Martin had sent me a text and said, give it away, mate.
If Mick Martin's telling you to give it away, and he only played up until last year himself.
Yeah, no, so it's done.
No,
great,
it's over.
A great cause. Well done to everybody involved. Pix, I tell you what, there was a footy club in a particular area of the Alodden Valley, I should say, that had won seven consecutive premierships.
Yeah, Bridgewater.
And were really cocky. Thought they'd get it done again for eight in a row.
That's what they did.
Well, our mates at the Calaville United Football Club, all the boys and girls involved there, just put a stop to that rot. And we've got Ron and Jordan Lee.
Rod, I should say,
from the Calaville United Football Club. And they join us on the program tonight. Gents, welcome. Congratulations.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks, pal.
It's good to be here, guys. Well done. They call themselves the Mean Machine, this other mob. They weren't so mean on the weekend, were they?
No. It was, it was really good to get out of the line, actually. So... first one I've actually won, so as a senior player, so it's been good.
It's a staggering performance, though. Seven in a row going in. They're the red-hot favourites in front of a pretty big crowd here. We're having a look at this. The game, I believe, at Serpentine. And now we're trying to find some great highlights of, except your number 18. Get a finger on it, man! Anyway, it was a brilliant win, because you were down by a couple of goals at half-time as well.
Yeah. So we started off pretty well in the first quarter, and then second quarter they got on top of us, and... we didn't have many answers, and then the third quarter they kicked the first goal, and I know something clicked after that, and we got on a roll.
How old are you now, Jordan?
I'm 26 now.
Now I want to go straight to you, Rod. This bloke played under 17 footy as a 9-year-old.
Well, you do that a bit in the country at times, just filling up numbers and making spots. So
nine, and he was playing under 17s.
Yeah, well, they had a jump. They had a lot of trouble getting a jumper to fit him.
Right.
let's have a look at the better players and the goal kicks. Mark Heasy. This is the vision. In a pretty spiteful game, I believe.
Yeah, there's over the years we've had a bit of history, us and Bridgewater, and there's been a few scraps like this over the years.
Let's cast it to Chase Jordan. You don't like this mob. You don't like this mob, mate. You can say it now, you got the flag. It's in the bank. It was a pretty spiteful game, though, through the course of the match.
Yes, there's a lot of little niggles in that during the match.
What about some of these players that you grew up with? Because it's a pretty... You've had players that you played in the 17s with. You're 26 now, as you say. You've been able to build a pretty good group of players that are actually from the area.
Yeah, back in 2003, we got, we're probably up in the air whether the juniors are going to have a team or not, and we got a coach by the name of Alan Stokes that came and brought a lot of players, and this is our first year. And
which one are you there, Jordan?
One of the short ones at the front there.
How old are you there?
I think I was about 12.
You played 50 games already, Picks, as a 12-year-old.
No one wanted to look at the camera there, of course. Look at big red in the front on the left there at the screen. And then it's a fair effort, though, you guys, coming through with a whole heap of your mates. Rod, you've been the president as well at the club, so, I mean, you must be pretty proud of what the boys have been able to do.
Oh, look, it's fantastic. Like local clubs, you just need a few people to do a bit, and then you just keep it going. You've got these young blokes and... the community is what you're all about, trying to keep going. And we've been lucky enough to to have that coming through, and it's good.
It's a tough caper for country footy clubs all over the state, but what does it mean to your organisation now that you've got a premiership again?
Well, Calaville actually don't have a town. There's a hall and a football ground. So
makes it a bit difficult, I would have thought. Not having a town.
No, so there's a lot of work to try and, you know, it was a dairy area, so there's a few people, but of course that's all getting thinner now, and to keep all that going and everything else, it's huge. And we get a lot of players out of Bendigo and that sort of thing, and they become locals, basically.
Okay, well, it's fantastic for the community. Oh, look at old mate's hair here. Now, tell us about your celebrations, because I believe we saw in the vision there a couple of blokes with real hair, sort of Tom Elvin style.
Yep.
What's happened this week with your Mad Mondays and the like?
Well, Saturday night, went back to the club rooms, and as you do, you have a few drinks. And, someone decided to bring the clippers out, and Ross Maxted, our old coach, doesn't mind having a shave of people's heads.
So there
was quite a fair few hairstyles going around on Mad Monday.
And there'd be a few blokes watching this show tonight that are trying to work out what happened between the final siren and, let's say, Tuesday. Who would you give the 3-2-1 for with the after-game celebrations?
Oh,
and honesty is required.
Honesty. Well, Lockie O'Neill would have to be up there, probably a good three. He's all year shown that he's pretty good off the field. Probably two would have to go to Bryce. He had a pretty solid off the field. And one, you toss it up in the air. I reckon Ross Max did. He went quite large there Saturday night. So.
Well, it's a fantastic performance,
absolutely,
isn't it, by the boys. Mm. And it's a reasonable drive to come in tonight to the show. And, I've done pretty good job these
two lads. I'm
tipping the premiership. Well, can we get maybe Jordan and
Rod,
Dad?
Yeah.
And Dad, hold the cup up. Just to give it to the mean machine one more time.
Right.
Grab a wing each.
Put it on.
There you go. Now, that's what they did. The mean machine were going for seven in a row.
Cop a bit of that, Bridgewater. Cop a bit of that, mate. Hey, that'll stoke the fire for next year, you blokes. Well, good luck with that, boys.
Probably what's happened is he stoked up the flame here. Now you guys are going to have to deal with it next year. It was a pretty spiteful game. Hey, guys, well done. Fantastic for the town. Fantastic effort. Well done to you, Jordan. Premiership player now, mate, as a senior player.
Yeah, you're still trying to get over it, really. Like, I played in the 2010 and we got flogged by Bridgewater. So, to get a bit of redemption's pretty sweet.
Well done to you. Well done. Thanks for coming in, Rod.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks for driving him down, Rod. He'll be asleep within 5 minutes. I'll be back in the car. I tell you what, well done to everybody there at Calaville United. We like to have a look at our Carlton Draft Team of the Week picks for a Victorian born and bred since 1864.
Yeah, it's this week's the team is the Swan Hill Mallee Eagles.
Famous club.
The Swan Hill Footy Club, basically. 16 premierships. Look at some of their legends.
Mm.
Fred Flanagan.
Oh, what a star.
What a superstar from the Geelong Football Club. And, of course, Jeff Rains, mm-hmm, another superstar premiership player for the Tigers.
Former Blues
and
player.
Callum Beasley, of course, there's a bit of vision. Beautiful.
This was a close game.
It's
a
wind
very,
grab,
very, very close game.
Yeah, well, Swan Hill, by a point.
As we like to say, bad kicking is?
Bad football.
Yep.
Bad football. The Mallee Eagles, I did say the Swan Hill Mallee Eagles. It was Swan Hill playing Mallee Eagles, of course. I played on that cricket on that ground, actually. It's a beautiful, warm area. Look how good the, I'm just letting you know.
You've just hijacked this and turned it into something.
No, I haven't, but I know the ground well. But a point win is a fantastic effort for Swan Hill. Kicked 7 goals straight in the third quarter, so wanted to get home, and they only got home by a solitary point.
Hey, just quickly, the community keg. We do like our Carlton draft family. The
we
community
do.
Keg is making its way around regional Victoria.
It is, and the major sort of grand final sort of set up, so Geelong Footy League, obviously the Ovens and Murray, the Murray Football League, and the Bendigo Football League. Now, we've said we'd go if Kyneton
Ring. 100%, I'm there, 100%, I promise you.
The Tigers were upset on the weekend. Oh. They're gone. They're out. So we're not going to the Bendigo.
That's
we might have to go to the
able to get your brother-in-law on the line, Robbie Waters.
Oh, he thinks he's Eddie McGuire at the Footy Club. There'll be questions being asked at the moment, I would have thought. So we won't be getting to the Bendigo League.
Yep.
Fine. We might get up to the Ovens and Murray or the Geelong Footy League.
All right, we look forward to that. That was our Carlton Draft Team of the Week, Victorian born and bred since 1864. When we come back, a big member of our team here, Nathan Currie from Channel 9 Local News with our Country Footy Roundup. And Off the Bench is all brought to you by the TAC. Drinking, driving, they're better apart. Safer speeds on our roads. A really important message from our great friends at the TAC and their Towards Zero campaign. Yeah, welcome back to Off the Bench. Thanks to the TAC Drinking Driving. They are much better apart, TAC Towards Zero. Great message and an important one from our dear friends at the TAC. Time now for our Country Footy Roundup. All thanks to Greyhound Racing, supporting 3,000 Victorian jobs as we welcome back the dancing, the harmonica playing, and the all-round good guy, Nathan Currie from Channel 9 Local News. Welcome, Nath.
Thanks, Potter. Good to be back, boys.
I've got to jump straight into it. The South West District Football League Grand Final was played and won.
Yeah, Dartmoor had a big win, and to make it even bigger, Haywood hadn't lost a game all season, and then they got done by a goal. Pipped in the last game of the year, really disappointing for them, but great signs for Dartmoor. It's their first flag as the Giants. The last flag they weren't, but it's because Jeremy Cameron, who came from that club.
Don't go there.
To mention the one that got away, Pickers, but yeah, so they're the now wearing the GWS colours there, as you can see. So that's really pleasing for them, but really good win for Dartmoor there to pip Haywood after they've been so good all year.
Yeah, disappointing for Haywood. Talking to one of our former teammates at North Melbourne.
Who's that?
Kevin Hap-Hughes on Saturday night. It's fair to say he just left the ground and he was pretty flat with Haywood's performance. But well done to the Giants. That's a fantastic effort. There's only a couple of other clubs that wear the Giants colours, I think, in the States. St Peter's and, of course, in the Geelong District and the Southern Mallee Giants. Where are we going now?
This is Nangerloch's grand final win over Gol in the Millawa Football League. Really pleasing for the Demons. He overcame a 13-point three-quarter time deficit to win their first premiership since 1995, which is great for them. For the Hawks, they've now lost two grand finals in a row, and disappointing considering that they were up at the final break and they also finished on top of the ladder. Now, I'm told the Demons had their best and fairest on Sunday. So they've had a big couple of days, those boys, I think.
How would the best and fairest winning speech go?
Well, I think Dowdy would have been off tap and Duth the same. Let's get up and Murray.
There's some more Demons that had a win. Yeah, they had a really big win. They lost last year's grand final, last premiership back in 2005, and they've lost four since then. So, and as you can tell by the result, they got to savour this one because they had it in the bag from about half time, I think.
Yeah, well done to Corio.
The preliminary final is locked and loaded in the Sunraysia Footy League.
United straight through to the grand final after getting the job done against Mildura. Incredible comeback by the Kangas. They kicked five goals in the final term after being down by 27 points at the final break. So really disappointing for Mildura there. But thankfully, they do get a double chance. They're playing against Irimple in the preliminary final this Saturday. Craig Beggs, their ruckman, is free to play. He got a suspended sentence at the tribunal, so that's good news for them at least.
Okay, one last chance. It's the beauty of having a double chance, I guess, straight into the prelim. And where are we off to now?
Central Highlands Footy League.
Yeah, great news for both. A really exciting week for them. They're into their first grand final since 2003. Haven't won a premiership since they went back-to-back in 1996. And they actually stopped Springbank from... they were going for a three-peat, won the last two, but... their chances are gone now. The Crows were far too good. Big year for them. Hannah Driscoll was just telling me their president gave a car a jump start at the start of the year too. So they're doing a lot of good things this year.
That's a real bit of news that we didn't really need to hear. But anyway, so I can't believe that Beaufort have actually got... They're the Beaufort Crows.
Yeah.
Because they were the Cats when I was growing up.
Okay.
I used to play footy against Beaufort and some junior stuff. And
things have changed.
Getting out of the Cats' colours and getting into the Crows' colours.
Well, it makes sense because they're winning.
Makes no sense.
No, it makes sense. So well done to them. What about a couple of brothers from the North Warrnambool Football Club making the AFL Ontario Team of the Year?
Yeah, Dean and Luke Gavin play for the Toronto Eagles over there. They've both been named in the Team of the Year and they're hopefully playing in a grand final in a few weeks. So I'm sort of a bit jealous. I sometimes think I could go overseas and maybe get a chance to play some sort of senior football competition. But yeah,
they
so
have best club
well.
Award over there too. Don't worry about that.
There's a bit of a North American flavour to a greyhound race.
Oh, what are we?
There is. So, yeah.
Avatar Flame.
Yeah, which is the white dog lane.
Where's the white dog?
The one with the white.
Number
three that's out in front by about six.
I thought you were referring to
and you know what? Avatar, it's sired by an American dog, KC and all. And the sister, Avatar Vixen, ran second, trained by the Hardigans in Horsham. So well done there to the Avatar team.
Yes.
And well done to you, Nathan.
Yes.
Thanks,
well done,
Nathan.
Looking forward to learning more about you next week on the program. That was our Country Footy Roundup. Thanks to Greyhound Racing, putting every dog first on and off the track. When we come back, the weekly wrap with Hannah Driscoll from the Weekly Times. But as we head to the break, Some incredible acting from two, well, one famous footballing star and another manager that just hangs around and dags off him, but some great acting for any very important cause. It's the TAC Safe Series with Isaac Smith and my man here.
Well, Isaac, the Rovers are getting into some serious goal-kicking practice. Mind you, it looks like they've got some issues, though.
They're definitely lacking in the balls department.
Very underwhelming indeed. Is that a balloon?
I believe it is, Pickers. Proof of just how much equipment matters here, but even more on the roads.
Correct. Hitting the road in a vehicle that's not up to scratch is about as useless as that squishy ball number 50's trying to wrangle. Airbags, auto-emergency braking and ESC are all key safety features. So before you buy your next car, find out more at howsafeisyourcar.com.au.
Welcome back to Off the Bench. Thanks to the TAC Drinking Driving. They are better apart TAC towards zero. Time now for our weekly wrap. Thanks to the Weekly Times, the voice of the country, as we welcome back Hannah Driscoll. Welcome, Hannah.
How are we going, guys?
It's award season, Hannah.
It is award season, and one of the big ones on Sunday night, they awarded the Moorish Medal. With Geelong Falcons' Grian Mears finished equal third, so he was 7 votes off the winner, so well done to him. They also announced the TAC Cup Teams of the Years for both the boys and the girls, so we'll have a look at those in a moment. Unsurprisingly, Grian making it in there. There are quite a few boys from the country in there.
That's Grian Myers at the back there, on the middle row on the left with the dreads.
Yep.
Lee Brown, of course, the coach, swatter.
Big Lee
sitting
Brown.
In the middle.
Hold on, Leroy.
From Gippsland Power. Mm-hmm. And from the girls' team, Darcy Guttridge, who'd just been named captain of the under-18 All-Australian. She was in this team. Actually, the back line for this TAC Cup team was very similar to the All-Australian girls' team as well. So well done to the country girls in that side.
Who just quickly, who won the Moorish Medal?
Jack Higgins.
Welcome to the club, Jack. With the grand final.
I wonder why you're asking that.
You had a drop in it.
We have a lot to, let's keep moving on. We have a lot of grand finals that will be played this weekend.
There is
Hannah.
A lot of grand finals on this week. So we'll run through a couple of them now. Just a lazy, I think, 10 this weekend.
Yeah.
Some of the highlights here, we've got North Bendigo and Leechville Gumbau. This will be the third time in a row that they've met in a Heathcote District grand final. North Bendigo has won the last two. So Leechville Gumbau looking to make the breakthrough. Old Collegians did the Haywood last year. They went through undefeated and got beaten in the final, so they're looking to win their first flag in more than 20 years. And Tura, great story from Tura. They are into their first grand final since 1989.
They won't beat Fish Creek.
And we'll
no
be
way.
Going, no, you reckon no, they'll pinch their first flag since 73?
No, I don't think so. The fish heads are really going well.
they're going very well, but look, hopefully it's a good game there.
It will
all
be.
Right, good luck to all of the teams playing this weekend. A football club that's close to your heart.
Oh, is it ever?
Rochester Football Club. We've got a wonderful feature story tonight.
Yeah, so there's a feature coming up on three retirees from the Rochester Tigers.
One of our first finals, against your old today over in Benalla. But it was a little bit more involved with a few of our club legends pulling up the boots. They made that announcement last week. So Elliot Bowen, Sammy Brennan and Heath Aiken.
Yeah, I guess I've been playing at Rochester my whole life. Played my first senior game in about 98. I've played probably about 240 games for Rochi. Had a couple of years off in between. Love the town, love the club, and wouldn't want to play anywhere else.
Highs is, for me, probably would have been my first year senior footy in 99. I was lucky enough to win a senior flag there, and as in year 11, so it was a great experience to be a part of. Look, it will be sad, emotional when it's all done and dusted, but the body's looking forward to giving it a rest as well.
Came in 2006, 2008, we made the GV Grand Final, playing against Seymour, goal going for 4 in a row. Probably were outnumbered in terms of quality and whatnot, but we pulled off a miracle and ended up beating Seymour by 3 points in the end on the biggest stage in the GV. It's really special to share in this, time. It's not a sad time. It's definitely time to put your hand up and say the body can't go anymore. But I find it extra special to be able to share this moment with two other great legends of the club.
It's been discussions over 3-4 weeks prior to last week, and we want to do it properly, and we wanted people to celebrate their careers. And then on the flip side, it might give the playing group that extra you know, 5-10%, and you know, just to keep going for those three as well, and it probably showed a little bit today.
The thing that stands out the most is just how important being a part of a club and a small community is. It's full of great people and full of role models, and yeah, I'm a much better person for being a part of the Rochester Footy Club, that's for sure. The mateship you make back there, and just the friends that you have, and friends for life you're going to have. Even though I live in Melbourne, I still get to catch up with him on the weekend, and it's great.
If the stars aligned and everything happened, that we could get to another grand final, and you know, with the group that we've got, knowing that the three of us are retiring, yeah, I think it will supersede the 2008 premiership. Just knowing how special it is, and who's moving on, but it's a long way to go.
You know, going down in the grand final last year to Kai Abram was something obviously that we wanted to improve on, but you know, you got to get there first, and you got to play good footy. So, you know, we'll take Shep Bears with the respect that deserves, and that Sunday next week.
Yeah, great story about Elliot, Sam and Heath. We wish you well, boys, and hope that it ends on the way that you would like to. Hannah, what about our photo of the week? Is it our man again?
It is our man. This is from the celebrations from the Loddon Valley Grand Finals. This is Calaville United boys celebrating after their big win. So congratulations again. Huge effort.
Yep. Thank you, Hannah. We appreciate you coming in. If you'd like to read Hannah's articles or catch up with the National Rural News Fresh Daily, you can do it right there, weeklytimes.com.au. We've got to take a break. When we come back, we've got the Great Country Clashes, and Pickers is in really red-hot dipping form. It's all thanks to the TAC. Drinking, driving, they are better apart. TAC towards zero. Welcome back to the show. Time now to take a look at our Great Country Clashes for the TAC. Drinking, driving, they're better apart. We can all save lives on our roads. Picks, where are we?
East Gippsland Football League Grand Final time, Swatter.
Yep. And Linda now.
Linda now. The Cats, Linda now, will get the job done. They are the red hot favourites at the Bairnsdale.
Yep.
2:15. Beautiful ground, Bairnsdale. 2:15.
Right. In a word, picks, Adelaide Giants.
Adelaide.
Geelong Richmond.
Cats.
Sydney Essendon.
Sydney.
Port Adelaide West Coast.
Port Adelaide.
Nicely
I think all the favourites will win, but you can make a case for all the upsets all right.
Good
as
luck
well.
To the AFL teams, and good luck to all the regional country football teams in Victoria and netball teams playing grand finals this weekend. Thanks for your company. Have a great week. We'll see you next week.